24/7's got it right. Covering girls' high school sports all the time. 100% free, 100% live. W7 for the girls.
One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.
Go that way. Really fast. Something gets in your way. Turn.
Yeah.
When someone asks you if you're a god, you say yes.
I want you to remember this face here, okay? This is the guy behind the guy behind the guy.
I feel like I'm taking crazy pills.
Kind of a big deal.
They've done studies, you know. 60% of the time, it works every time.
How about that?
Come on! Quit stalling!
7 live. Not inside the Fix TV Dub Dome at Colburn Park here along the shores. It feels like we're along the shores of like Antarctica. Left the Dub Dome in the house, in the garage. Be a lot better place for it out here. I don't know why I didn't think about bringing it today, Dom. But hey, you're watching the 360U pregame show for today's game between the visiting Sheboygan North Golden Raiders and the host Notre Dame Tritons. Dom D'Angelo alongside me. We got some modified windscreens. But before we get to the pregame, let's talk a little bit about 360U, sponsor of today's pregame show. Founded in 2016, the mission of 360U is to provide superior softball and baseball training to our athletes to empower them to become the most confident, complete versions of themselves. At 360U, we are proud to be a family-owned business that is passionate about offering the best softball and baseball training for our athletes. Our training environment is a welcoming and family-oriented, providing a safe and nurturing space for players to develop their skills. Visit the360u.com to learn more. That's the360u.com. I tell you what, a lot of good stuff going on. Good stuff going on down there at 360U. It's more than, Dom, I don't know about it, but it's just more than just softball and baseball. They talk the mental side of things. They talk, you know, they really build the players up and the confidence and all and everything else that goes into making a complete athlete. You know, so even if baseball, softball's secondary or third sport, great opportunity to pick something up that'll carry over to your other sports or life lessons for that matter. But hey, we got a good one on tap here this afternoon, Dom. We got Parents Night here for the Tritons, so we'll, a little bit of an extended pregame show, but you got the lineups in, and we'll get to those in a second. Notre Dame, they come in 2-3 overall. You know, I mean, they played a tough West Superior team, tough Oshkosh West team, so very, I would say, battle-tested here early in the early goings. You know, West Superior, they lost 5-11. Oshkosh West was a 9-6 setback. Then they played Manitowoc. That was 13-2. And then the always difficult Preble Hornets. That one was a lopsided loss in the favor of the Hornets. And then nice bounce back, though, against Sheboygan South on Tuesday afternoon. Nice 21-0 win there. So you put Monday and Tuesday's game together, and they went 1-1, and it was 22-19 was the final outcome between those two games. Notre Dame came on top. They are plus 3 across those 2 days.
Yeah, it's going to be tough to match that 21 point out of here with the wind conditions like you can probably see on the screen here. I think what's going to be most interesting for Notre Dame coming into this game is going to be, you know, like you said, already played a couple games this week. It's Friday afternoon. Do they have a ton of energy still in the tank to kind of get through this game here in a really efficient manner like they have in their 2 wins this year?
Yeah, you talked about it. It's going to be I don't know how you can come out of this game with any ball that's popped up that's not caught. It's definitely got to be a hit. It's not going to be an error because the wind is going to play with it, all sorts of things. You know, we were talking about this before we went on air, Dom. It's like, how do you play in the outfield? And other than personally, anything that hits to the outfield, you just turn around back to the infield. It's almost like a catcher, that the ball is going to spin back and come back to the infield. So you want to be basically ahead of it by having your back to the infield and let it come to you versus trying to chase it, and turn it into a diving catch. But it's going to be interesting, to say the least. If anybody puts a home run out today, I put a little friendly wager on there. I said I'll get Starbucks for anybody that puts one over the fence off the bat, because it's definitely going to be a poke. But hey, it's now time for our Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin Out on a Limb prediction with locations in Pewaukee, Mequonago, and Brookfield. Avoid lines and meet with orthopedic providers who specialize in sprains, strains, fractures, and lacerations, dislocations, and more. Visit orthowisconsin.com. Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. There is a difference. Dom, when we get to, as we look down there at Parents Night, But as we get to our out on a limb prediction, what are your, what's your prediction here this afternoon?
The weather conditions like they are, we talked about the score difference. 22-19. I'm going that in this game, it's going to be a good old-fashioned pitcher's duel. The most amount of runs scored in this game is 5, by the way.
Well, you're going 5 pitcher's duel. And with the winning team coming out with just 5 runs. All righty. Well, hey, my out on a limb prediction is I think somebody is going to put one out. It's going to be I think it's going to be late in the game. All right. The wind's going to die down as we go throughout the night. And I really think somebody could put one out. All you got to do is get it lifted in the center field and then let it carry out kind of over to the right field scoreboard. As you look down there, the wind's going to carry it. Well, hey, that's the 360U pregame show. When we come back, we will have first pitch. 360U is the go-to destination for softball and baseball training. Ready to get started? Go to 360U.com and book a new athlete lesson. These lessons are for softball and baseball athletes of any skill level who are new to 360U training. These lessons will be held, will help find the training schedule that best fits your needs. Visit the360u.com. Thank you for watching the 360U pregame show. National Anthem starting lineups are coming up next.
W7's got it right. Covering girls' high school sports all the time. 100% free, 100% live. W7 for the girls.
Parents' night here at Notre Dame at Colburn Park. While we got a minute, speaking of parents, some of these sponsors, some of their businesses, and friends of their parents would all make, you know, Triton softball possible. Quick shout out to the following businesses that help support Triton softball: All Wisconsin Tree Services, Big Care Orthopedic Sports and Medicine, Bay Area Granite and Marble, Happy Joe's Pizza, KI, Kemp's Ace Hardware, Ornu, Rukert Milky, Starry's Realty, Synergy, Schutz Bar and Grill, Schneider, Stat Information Solutions, Townline, 360U, Velocity, and Whipfleet. Huge shout out to all those businesses that help make Notre Dame Triton softball successful, supporting them all throughout the year, not just during the season, and also some of those jumping on, becoming partners and sponsors of W7 this year as well. So big thank you to all of them. No time better than right now, Dom, to get involved and support girls' athletics. We saw that with the Final Four.
Couldn't agree more. It's blooming all over the place, and it's really a joy and a privilege to, one, be able to document it and be a part of it, but also just see how big it's become on such a national stage.
Yeah, I don't know if we're ever going to get 19.7 million viewers on a game, but, you know, maybe if we can get 19.7, that'll be a start. No, we've got a ton of great viewers and supporters and followers. We appreciate it. Speaking of viewers, if you are tuning in, drop in the comment section there where you're watching from, who you're cheering for. We'll get to those shout-outs as the game progresses. Home plate meeting underway right now, and so we will be underway shortly as we eat a ton of sand here behind our home plate. The wind just blowing in right off the diamond, but wouldn't have it any other way. I tell you what, I love softball season, but I love when it's 78 and sunny.
Yeah, yeah, a lot better that way.
Go over to ground rules. Coach Scott pointing the left field. I don't think left field's going to come into play too much today, Scott, with the wind blowing in. But that's all right. Sheboygan North, Notre Dame set to do battle here. In just a moment, we'll step away. When we come back, we'll have starting lineups for you. You're watching W7 presented by Jolly Good Soda, Fix TV.
Let me ride through the water.
All righty, back all set, ready to go here for first pitch. Leading things off for Sheboygan North will be number three there, shortstop Mara Babick, followed by number four, Emma Wagner, followed by number one, Bella Wagner. So that'll be the first three. Any of those reach, it'll be number 12, Elena Reeder, and if they can extend the inning, number five, the center fielder, Jaden Yetzer. Get a scoreboard up for y'all and settle in here for a, what is hopefully a fantastic softball game. Sun's starting to set. Got to get that hat back on there, Dom.
Well, my hat doesn't quite fit with the headsets here. For those who know me well, today's the famous Fedora Friday in the D'Angelo household. And one was upstairs to Babick, the shortstop. Addie Simpson is the pitcher on the mound today for Notre Dame. Does a lot of pitching for the Tritons. Here comes a sandstorm. She will hold up for a second. Now fires a pitch. And that's outside for a ball. 3-1 count.
Well, I tell you what, it would have been a great day for the Dub Dome.
We're sitting in a wind dome. Boy, this is going here.
Yeah, well, the Dub Dome forgot to bring the Dub Dome.
That one's in there, first strike, a drop strike by a wall drop, full count, 3-2.
Boy, the wind's just blowing the cameras around and moving around on the fences real good. That's all right. Can't tell, though. You look at those clouds, and they're just sitting still.
That's ball four, a leadoff walk.
Well, we got a minute left to right for the Tritons in the outfield. Yanner, Gelb, Siminski, third to first on the infield. Ella Gelb, Peters, Massey, Hiltz, and as Don mentioned, Simpson in the circle. Wall drop doing the catching this afternoon.
Emma Wagner, the left fielder, shows bunt. Runner is in a bit of a jam here to get back to first in time. Well, you don't want to be hosed down by Kaya Waldrop there behind the dish.
That's flirting with disaster out there.
Next pitch from Simpson down low. Runner goes once again. Throw down to second is, I believe, in time, so that's out number one.
I told you, you're flirting with disaster. When we talked about it, you don't want to test Kyle Waldrop. So the leadoff walk retired right there. Nice job by Waldrop. Peters applying the tag out there at second base.
Next pitch from Simpson. A bunt is laid down to no effect there. That's out number two. Waldrop fired it down to first.
So now two outs. Wow, we got a moment. Tonight's broadcast powered by Jolly Good Soda. Visit jollygoodsoda.com and enter your zip code to find the nearest retailer near you. We also encourage you to visit their website to find some tremendous vintage style apparel. Make sure to use the promo code for the girls to get 17% off all merchandise. Jolly Good Soda puts the pop in Wisconsin.
Bella Wagner, the third baseman, facing Simpson for the first time today. Swings and fouls one back out of play, and even on a ball in foul territory, the wind took that one for a bit of a ride there. Wagner wearing number one. Sheboygan North in their navy blue uniforms today. Good pitch from Simpson for a strike.
Got some comments rolling in. Cheering on Sheboygan North, and we also got another one. Carla Schmidt cheering on the Tritons. So keep those comments coming. Unlike many other live streamers, we like to be as interactive as possible. So go ahead, pop that in the comment section there, where you're watching from, who you're cheering for. Not just the team in general, but the individual.
Good breaking pitch there from Simpson. That's strike three, and that ends the inning. So they get around the leadoff walk. Wagner is retired. Triton's coming up to bat in the bottom half of the first.
My younger brother got me into cycling about 15 years ago. After I was injured and the cartilage started to wear out in my left hip, he said, I just became sedentary. Orthopedic Associate took such good care of me. I went in one day, came home the next day. 9 months after my hip surgery, I did a 150-mile bike ride. It's just been a great experience. I'm back doing everything that I was doing and more.
Back here, bottom of the first, we head. Hey, Fix TV provides live streaming and recorded content available on Fire TV, Roku TV, and Apple TV. Also, make sure you download their free mobile app on Apple and Android. Get your fix with Fix TV, and that's Fix spelled PHYX TV. You can catch all of W7 games either on, of course, YouTube, or download that app and you can get it right on your big screen via Apple or Roku or Fire TV. So lots of options. We're expanding our network and able to get girls high school sports to you as easily and accessible as possible. As the Golden Raiders complete their warm-ups, we'll go over their defensive alignment here to start the game. It'll be Wagner in left, Jetzer in center, and Ulrich in right field. Third to first on the infield, Wagner, Babic, Sohn, Ritter. Brandis in the circle and doing the catching duties this afternoon will be Ashworth. Larissa Peters will get things underway here for the Tritons. Their home half of the first. See if she can't spark a little rally here.
Swings at the first pitch from the pitcher Brandis. Popped up. Nice play made there by the shortstop Babbitt going out to get it. So Peters is retired on the first pitch.
Yeah, that.
That's your routine that, fly ball.
That was actually Jetzer, the center fielder, fielding it basically in the 3-4 gap. That's what we're talking about, that win right there. So one pitch, one out here for Brandis.
Yonder sends another high pop fly, this one on the infield. That one's gonna drop, that'll be a base hit.
See, that's one of those things that we were talking about before, Dom. 99% of the time, that's shortstop ball, but with the wind blowing in so hard from left field, that second baseman's got to take over back to the first baseline. The ball's going to drift right back into her glove, and it's routine.
Connor's going. Fire down to second is not in time, so she will steal a bag.
Games like this with all the wind, it just completely messes with the normal. You got to do things backwards today. Hit the ball, run the third.
Addie Simpson batting in the third spot today. She's pitching as well. Me and Gary made a comment about this last time we were together. Not often you see a pitcher batting third in a lineup, but that's how talented of a player she is.
Now, there's a select few across the state, and that's about it.
Next pitch to her is down low. Yonner is stealing a bag, heading down to third. She will be there safely. Good base running.
Nice delayed steal there by Yonner. Good luck there at Yonner down at third. Simpson in the box. Looking to help her own cause.
Simpson showed bunt for a moment and pulled it back. That's a called strike from Brandis.
Go, it almost feels automatic. If Yanner gets on, like, she's going to score no matter what. She'll manufacture her own run.
That one popped in foul territory behind the bleachers and out of play.
Yeah, that might have been playable last week.
Stood no chance this afternoon.
Hey, SBS Plumbing. No matter how large or small your construction project may be, SBS Plumbing is your go-to. Why work with us? It's simple, really. We are the best, and our process is the best. Our attention to detail is second to none. Plumbing every home as if it were our own.
That's a base hit to center. A run comes in to score. Simpson will turn for a hard turnaround first. He will settle with a single, and that makes it 1-0.
I tell you what, today's goal is just put bat on ball, get it in the air somewhere. Good things are going to happen.
So that'll bring up Kyle Waldrop, batting cleanup. Also doing the catching this afternoon. Simpson's going, throw down to second. Is not in time, she'll steal a bag, so. Already activating the base runners here are the Tritons.
Well, I think it's a smart move by Coach Hermes. With the wind blowing in, it's gonna really slow that ball down.
Yeah.
So why not get the runners going?
Next pitch to Waldrop is down low.
So I really need the wind to pick up because. I mean, there's a couple kids on this squad that could hit a home run out, but Kaya would be 1A, 1B, and 1C. So she'd be the one to win the bet.
Takes a ball outside there. 3-0 the count. That's a called strike one.
One right at the top of the numbers there. So 1-0 Tritons here early on the Image 360 New Berlin, Wisconsin scoreboard. Looking to add to it.
Swing and a fly ball drifting towards right field, playable. Old Rick has to chase it. She'll make the catch. Simpson will tag and head down to third.
Yeah, that one was skied to center field and ended up over there right in front of the scoreboard out in right field.
I mean, that looked like initially off the end of the bat, that was going to straightaway center, drifted all the way back into right field.
Nice job out there by Oldrick making it look like a routine play.
That'll bring up Ella Gell playing third base today. First pitch to her is down low. Gelb electing to wear the sweatshirt with her name on the back. Probably smart with some of the wind conditions. Can get chilly quite quick. Second pitch downstairs.
I want to put it past Gelb to put down a bunt here. I've seen her do it a time or two over the last couple years.
Swings and misses there. Ball gets away. Simpson's coming home and she'll score some more aggressive base running. And another run crosses the plate. It's now 2-0.
I'll tell you what, nice job there by Simpson reading it right away in the dirt. She took off without hesitation.
So a steal of home for Addie Simpson. Here's another sandstorm for you.
Everybody gonna back off here and give it a reset. I got three games tomorrow and I'm pretty sure I'm gonna take the entire diamond home with me tonight. I had to dust everything off tonight, my goodness.
There's that bunt you were calling for, it goes foul.
Watch the Gelbs play. Game or two of softball over the last 3 years. I remember being, I can't remember where the park was, but a little north of here, Gallup's there, freshman. I mean, just kind of, they're the ones really kind of sticking this one out, helping rebuild and provide a great culture to the program here.
Called strike three. Gelb is retired, and that is the end of the first inning. 2-0 Notre Dame after one over Sheboygan North.
Pain's a very lonely place. I came to Orthopedic Associates because I had a ruptured disc in my neck. I needed to get it fixed as soon as I could. Life immediately following the procedure is better. I have three young boys, I coach their sports, I play their sports with them. So just the joy in life came back. The pain was gone. The entire standard of life became better.
Top of the second we head here at Colburn Park. You think we are playing in the Great Plains of Iowa or Nebraska with the way the wind's blowing across here. But early 2-0 lead here for the Tritons on the Image 360 New Berlin, Wisconsin scoreboard. And right back over Dom DeAngelo at the play-by-play here in the top of the second.
Leading off this inning for Sheboygan North will be Elena Ryder. She swings and sends one foul back into the fence. So the Raiders looking to get some movement on the bases here. Ryder facing Simpson. The pitch to her is upstairs. I gotta tell you, these little windbreakers that you put on the microphones here are working like a dandy. That pitch is upstairs, 2-1.
Yeah, well, you know, and the microphones have a windscreen, but they're not rated for 25, 30 mile an hour, so you gotta modify a little bit.
2-1 count here. That one's downstairs from Simpson, so Ryder working with the hitter's count.
Look good from our view.
Three-one pitch from Simpson, down low, ball four. Another leadoff walk to begin the second. So Ryder's aboard, that'll bring up Hayden Yetzer.
Did you know Hummingbird Apparel works with over 200 schools in Wisconsin with in-house design, in-person delivery to ensure no shipping fees? Hummingbird Apparel can't be beat. Visit hummingbirdapparel.org to learn more. Oh, Dom, you stop and you think about it. Over 200 schools in the state of Wisconsin, there's only about 550 school districts. Mm-hmm. I mean, obviously multiple schools in a district, but you're working with a good chunk of them.
That one was fouled back into the fence right in front of us there, so 1-1 the count. On Yitzer, the center fielder, wearing number 5. That one's a called strike two.
So both teams getting the leadoff runner aboard here. Second time here for Sheboygan North.
That ball gets away. It didn't go very far into right field.
Excellent backup out there by Siminski.
And now Ryder in a little bit of discomfort, had to dive back to the bag. Shaking her right hand a little bit.
I think a little jam job there coming back into the base. She'll shake it off, rub a little dirt on it. She's ready to go again, 0-2 count.
Pitch to Yitzer, swung and fouled back out of play.
I think the little kids over there just avoided a nightmare.
Yeah, that could have been bad. I thought initially it ended up in the trash can over there, which that would have been a pretty sweet trick shot, but it did not. That one fouled back out of play.
Yeah, nice little battle going on here between Simpson and Yitzer.
Here's the pitch, that one outside for a ball. So now the count's full, 3-2.
Tell you what, nice job too by the city here. And of course, Notre Dame softball putting this field together.
Fly ball left field, playable. Yonner's got it, she makes the catch for the first out of the inning. So Yitzer is retired, that'll bring up Elena Sun.
Every time I come out here, field's looking better and better, Dom. Give this baby another year and a half, 2 years, and it's gonna be looking crisp.
First pitch swung on and fouled out of play. Yeah, they choose the best fields here at Colburn. There's about three or four of them in a little corner radius here, but really nice job by all the grounds crew getting us ready to play here. Swing and a miss there from Sun, so quickly nothing and two. Next pitch from Simpson is upstairs for a ball. Just missed that outside corner. The 1-2 from Simpson, swing and fouled out of play. Seen a couple of good battles here. In the top half of the second, next pitch from Simpson. It's a called strike three, delayed call from the home plate umpire, but Sun strikes out looking. That's out number two.
But Dom, you know, you go all the way back to the top of the first inning and Waldrop throwing off the leadoff batter at second. And I think it's kind of stymied the run game here a little bit.
That first pitch to Madeline Ashworth, the catcher, was outside for a ball.
Ritter just kind of hanging out down there at first base. Not real aggressive.
That one ripped down the line, foul. So a 1-1 count on the catcher, Ashworth. Elena Ryder still down at first. Next pitch, swing and a ground ball played by Gelb at third. Nice play from Ella Gelb, retires the side. Sheboygan North does not score. They leave a runner stranded. Triton's coming up to bat in the bottom half of the second. They lead it 2-0 when we return on W7, powered by Jolly Good Soda. We put the pop in Wisconsin.
Back here, bottom of the second, 2-0 lead for the Tritons on the Image 360 in New Berlin, Wisconsin scoreboard. Before we get the bottom of the second rolling, Bay Area Granite and Marble, we have lasting relationships with our customers through trust, competitive prices, customer satisfaction, and a rejuvenating transformation of each customer's unique project. Visit BAGM, that's BAGM.com, to learn more. Three locations, Appleton, Suamico, and Wrightstown, serving all of Northeast Wisconsin, as well as the UP.
Stella Starry will lead off the home half of the second, the designated player today. Left-handed bat wearing number 44, takes a ball upstairs. Here's a pitch from Brandis inside for another ball.
I tell you what, Stella, I mean, like I said before, a couple kids on this lineup that could take it over the fence. Stella's another one. She had a home run earlier this year. And from that left-handed batter's box, she can turn on one, use that wind to her advantage.
Serious pop in that bat. That's a four-pitch walk. So Starry is aboard. That'll bring up Manny Hiltz, the first baseman. First pitch to her is upstairs. Saw a lot of aggressive base running in that first inning. Be interested to see what Starry does here.
I'll look for her to be aggressive if anything kind of gets away from that batter's box area.
Swing and a ground ball, third base side, taken by Wagner. Throw across is not in time. So everyone is safe. Nice stop there from Wagner to keep it from anything more than a single, but just a little late with the throw.
And a little preservation down there of self-defense at the hot corner.
Next pitch to Gelb. Megan this time, he called for a bunt from her sister earlier, showed one there.
This has got that scenario. She's going to try twice to sacrifice, bunt him over, then getting the hole 0-2 and rip one into the gap.
Ooh. One taken for a ball.
I think catcher sold that one as high as she sits down on that, does Ashworth. She kind of popped up out of her stance.
Next pitch, swing and a miss.
Nice change of speed there. Out of the hands is Brandis.
So 1-2 the count now on the center fielder, Gelb. Ava Massey waiting in the on-deck circle. 2-1, that one swung and fouled back.
Tell you what, we got a great view of them coming back here.
Sure do. Thank goodness for this fence in front of us here, otherwise we would have eaten a couple of these. Still 1-2, here's the pitch. That one gets away from Ashworth, runners will advance. So now two in scoring position. Starry moves down to third, Hiltz at second.
So now the job changes just a little bit here for Gelb, thinking about getting it. Getting something in the outfield now, scoring a run via in the air or even on the ground. Find some green grass.
Next 1-2 pitch. Upstairs, ball two, count even.
I believe that was ball three. We'll find out here if it's a payoff pitch or not.
Swing and a miss. Gelb strikes out.
Big first out there for Brandis. See if she can't pitch herself out of a little bit of a jam.
That was out number one of the inning. Ava Massey, the second baseman, now in the batter's box. Swing, and that one's ripped down to left field. That's down for a base hit. They will hold Hiltz at third as Starry comes around to score. It's an RBI single, and the lead grows to three.
No job too big or small for all Wisconsin Tree Services. We offer year-round services for your home or commercial properties, including tree removal, stump grinding, tree trimming, forestry clearing, 24/7 emergency storm cleanup, and much, much more. Visit allwitreeservices.com or give them a call, 920-661-7102.
A little bit of a trickery with the stealing there. Hiltz bluffed, so the throw went down to third. That allowed Massey to advance down to second. Back to the top of the order, Clarissa Peters. Flew out to center on a not-so-routine fly ball back in the first.
Yeah, center fielder catching it on the right field line.
Tough play here for Barbic. Gets it across, not in time. One run comes in to score. Here comes Massey, and she will score as well. That makes it 5-0.
Well, Dom, you were muted, but our orthopedic associate's out on a limb prediction was winning team was going to have five, so I guess we go home?
Yeah, let's call it a day.
Why not? All right. Speaking of Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, locations in Pewaukee, Maguanago, and Brookfield, avoid lines and meet with orthopedic providers who specialize in sprains, strains, fractures, lacerations, dislocations, and more. Visit orthowisconsin.com.
You may get yours there. That one is over the head of the left fielder, Wagner. Another run comes in to score. And now they're in a little bit of a jam here. Ball gets away. Yonner will be safe at third.
Yonner hit the brakes. She's getting ready to head back to second. You know, I never clarified either if it had to be in the park or over the fence.
That was good on your part.
No, that's terrible on my part.
Oh.
Because that was almost an in-the-park home run, it could have been.
I thought the goal of these was to get them right.
Yeah, well, I suppose. Now 7-0 Tritons on the image, 360. New Berlin and Wisconsin scoreboard. A little visit to the mound out there. Found the organ on the way to the game today, though, Dom.
Sounds good. I've found a new appreciation for the organ. I had a chance to meet an organist the other day, and that was... I don't know if you've ever seen one with all the knobs and everything they got going on. It's impressive stuff. Addie Simpson sends one into the fence out of play.
Just like the hometown scoreboard operator, I was a little aggressive too, making it 7-0. Just 6-0 on the image 360 New Berlin, Wisconsin scoreboard.
Okay, you had me concerned for a second. I was looking at my, I have a paper copy scorecard here, and I was looking, I'm like, wait, where did I miss one?
Yeah, well, you know. Just one dead. Simpson looking to help her own cause. Oh, we got a foul ball out here from the other field.
I would have said that's the second furthest place the ball's landed in the yard today, but after that Yonner triple, that's not true.
You know, Yonner might have found a little power alley down that left field line, kind of protected by the wind there.
Real good swing. Ground ball here taken by Babick. Fires across the diamond in time. That's out number two. Another run will score. So you hit it right with seven, just a tad too early.
There's a second or third one out there this half inning over to Babick. Nice job recovering, staying in the game. coming up cleanly with that one, making the play that time.
Pitch to wall drop is swung and fouled back.
Tell you what, Kai ain't getting cheated with these swings.
Swing and a miss there. Waldrop 0 for 1 today. Hit a fly ball to right, her last time up. O-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. So Waldrop is retired. 5 come across home plate, though. It's now 7-0 in favor of Notre Dame. We'll be back for the top half of the third. Right after this, you're watching Notre Dame Girls Softball on W7, powered by Jolly Good Soda.
Sportsmanship doesn't stop when the game ends. It's part of the community you live in. Respect, character, dignity. Your community, your team. We're a proud sponsor of the WIAA Rural Mutual Insurance Sportsmanship Award and have been since it began. It recognizes that sportsmanship matters in your community. Visit ruralmutual.com/WIAA and see how our team and your community can work together to be true champions.
There we go, wind picking up here, top of the third. It's gotta get worse before it gets better, Dom. About another 10, 15 minutes of this wind and we're smooth sailing for the final 3.5 innings.
Emily Brandis, the pitcher, will lead things off. Top half of the third here from Colburn Park.
Call it Wind Farm U right now.
Pitch from Simpson, swing and a ground ball, be taken by Peters.
Oh, nice job by Clarissa. Setting her feet, firing a bullet across the diamond.
So that's out number one. Have a nothing game here. First pitch down low to Animal Utech, the designated player today.
Yeah, we got another softball in center field. Oh, we got a moment. Bay Area Granite Marble, one of the largest and fastest growing stone fabrication installation companies in the Midwest. Visit BAGM.com to learn more. That's BAGM.com to learn more. Appleton, Suamico, Wrightstown, serving all of Northeast Wisconsin and the UP. Give them a call, 920-662-1300. Let them know W7 sent you. Maybe you get that nice, like, black and red quartz.
I went downstairs, ball two. So 2-1 the count now on UTEC. Next pitch to her, ball three, 3-1 count now. On the north DP. Swing and a little bouncing ball, be taken by Simpson once she gains control in time. That's out number two.
Another nice job there by Simpson. Didn't fueled it cleanly right off the bat, taking her time, understanding she had the time to make a good throw over there.
Back to the top of the order. Marababa gets that one down and left. Fell right in front of Yonner. So a two-out single for the Sheboygan North shortstop.
Fix TV provides live streaming and recorded content available on Fire TV, Roku TV, and Apple TV. Also, make sure you download their free mobile app on Apple and Android. Get your fix with Fix TV, PHYX TV.
That pitch upstairs to Emma Wagner, who tried to lay down a bunt her last time up.
I think Bavick's going again down there at first.
Bavick bluffs. Now she's going to go for second. Throw is not in time, just missed.
Yeah. There you go. There's my answer. Anybody claim that billion-dollar Powerball yet?
I was gonna say, you're pretty accurate
I'm
so far.
I'm pretty good right now, right? Oh, yeah. Well, I hit that billion-dollar Powerball, Dom, and you won't see me for a while.
Mm.
You'll have to take over pushing the buttons. Yeah. Don't worry. I'll buy you a coach, teach you up how to do it.
Okay, that's good. That one way upstairs. Three balls and a strike.
I'll be somewhere with sand and it ain't gonna be a softball diamond.
There you go. That sand's probably gonna be privately owned, isn't it?
It might be.
Wagner walked, so two on with two out here in the top of the third. First pitch to Bella Wagner is outside for a ball.
So a little two-out trouble now here for Simpson in the top of the third.
Swing and a pop fly on the infield, playable. Massey will make the catch, and that will put out the fire in the top half of the third. Sheboygan North does not score. They leave two stranded. We'll go to the bottom half of the third with the Tritons leading 7-0 on the Image 360 New Berlin scoreboard. This is the score. You're listening and watching Notre Dame Girls Softball on W7 powered by Jolly Good Soda.
Here for the bottom of the third. Big shout out to the following sponsors of Triton Girls Softball. All Wisconsin Tree Services, Baycare Orthopedic Sports Medicine, Bay Area Granite and Marble, Happy Joe's Pizza. I can go for some Happy Joe's Pizza. KI, Kemp's Ace Hardware, Ornu, Rukert Milky, Starry's Realty, Synergy, Schutz Bar and Grill. First pitch swinging there was Gelb. Didn't Gelb know we were going through the food sponsors here? My goodness.
Those are the important ones there.
So Schutz Bar and Grill, Schneider, Stat Information Solutions, Townline, 360U, Velocity, and Whipfleet.
First pitch is way upstairs to Stella Starry, who walked her first time up.
Here you go. Wind starting to set, Dom. Here it comes.
There you go. I was concerned here because I had my hand on my fedora the whole time because can't have that blown away. This is a banner day in the Fedora Friday world these days. Second pitch way upstairs.
I mean, you only got a couple more left in the school year, my friend.
I know. Can you believe this? This is the first time I tried this. I got through a whole day without getting told to take it off by any teachers.
Wow. Well, maybe they just like it is.
Maybe they just like, hey, it's a Friday in April. We don't care. But
they've just finally accepted it. Nice change of speed there by Brandis. Starry way out in front.
Big swing and a miss on a good breaking pitch. Yeah, it's picking up steam in the, or at least I would like to think it's picking up steam. Fly ball left field. Heading in foul territory is Wagner. It goes out of play.
Hey, Image 360 New Berlin, from business signs to office signs. Image 360 New Berlin's expert team focuses on delivering superior quality graphics and displays while ensuring they meet your time frame and budget. Visit image360newberlin.com. Tell you what, I could use the sign right in front of us here today to block that wind. That would be nice, huh?
Be super good. Swing and a miss there. Starry is retired. That's out number two.
Use a nice little, like, 8x4, 8 feet wide, 4 feet high. Put that right on the fence.
Pitch to Hiltz is inside to put a wrap on this thing here. You had your cowboy hat when we were doing basketball for a while there. So
I did. Oh yeah, picked that up in Nashville with the kid. Went down there with the kids.
Maybe next year whenever you have a Friday game and you're coming to Notre Dame, we'll have to rock it out on the air together.
We might.
Big swing and a miss there. Now one more shout out I gotta give to one of my teachers, Mrs. Julie Campbell, who is a big supporter of the Fedora Friday movement. Maybe that's why it's picking up steam there.
Yeah, exactly. Just gonna speak it into existence.
Speak it into existence. Exactly right. That's ball two. 2-1 count.
I mean, the thing is, if everybody else just got on board with it, it'd be
kind of a fun thing.
It'd be the thing, right? Hiltz takes that one up high. So three balls, one strike, two outs here to Matty Hiltz. Batting in the seventh spot this afternoon.
Same as her jersey number seven.
She's got one of those seven runs on the Image 360 New Berlin, Wisconsin scoreboard.
Swings and fouls that one back into the fence.
That was camera high.
I was gonna say, it gives the camera a good shake there. Next one fouled back, out of play. Count stays full. Good battle here between Hiltz and Brandis.
53 pitches on the afternoon for Brandis, 31 in there for strikes. Face 15 batters, giving up just four hits. Three of the runs earned, four unearned.
Another 3-2 pitch. That one, a fly ball, hooking foul territory, long one run for Wagner. She will not make the catch.
I tell you what, about a half hour ago, that might have got pushed back into playable.
So 3-2 remains the count, two out, bottom half of the third. Payoff pitch from Brandis, a swing and a miss. A 1-2-3 inning for Sheboygan North. The Tritons do not score. They left nobody on base. No errors in that inning for the Sheboygan North Red Raider defense. 7-0 remains the score. We go to the top of the fourth right after this. You're watching W7.
Back here, top of the fourth. Dom, I tell you what we could use from Hummingbird Apparel. We can use another layer of jackets. Why Hummingbird Apparel? Unlike the large companies like BSN, who make you sign contracts and are a two to three month turnaround, we have no contracts and are typically a 2 week turnaround on all orders. Visit hummingbirdapparel.com.org.
That one a fly ball to left. Tough play there for Yonner. She made the catch. Not as routine as you would think, thanks to the wind.
We were just talking about who the player of the game might be. It might be Yonner. I got to talk about the carnival that's out there in left field.
Yeah. Nice swing there from Jaden Yetzer. That falls for a base hit. She will hold with a long single as she poked that one into center.
You know, and the Sheboygan North's had success. They've been jumping on that first pitch of Simpson.
Really seems like they've changed their approach a little bit from the first inning, really going after that first pitch to your point. Swing and a miss there from Elena Sun, who struck out looking her first time up. That was back in the second.
Yeah, so if you're Simpson, you don't want to groove one, right? You want to pick the corners. Maybe if you're going to chase that first one, get him to chase out of the zone.
That one fouled back quickly, nothing in two. Papers are flying everywhere.
I don't know
here.
What we lost, but hey, whatever. What did we lose? Oh, yeah.
Just the sponsors, yeah.
Well, we'll get that back tomorrow. You know what we need? We need a printing and paper sponsor.
Ooh.
So we can print those babies off every time. You know, like a FedEx Kinko's. That's what we need next.
That one outside for a ball. I like what you said last time. A hot cocoa sponsor would be good, too.
Oh, yeah. Hot cocoa, coffee, you know.
I'll take either.
You know, what is it, Knopf's Vending?
Ooh, yes.
They got good cocoa. Quick Trip, Karuba Gold. Not going to argue.
Mm-mm. Open for business here.
Yeah.
2-2 count here. Swing and a little pop fly on the infield. This can turn two, and they will. Nice play from Clarissa Peters there playing at short. That's going to end the top half of the fourth on a fantastic double play ball from Clarissa Peters. 7-0 is the score. Triton's coming up to bat right after.
stop the rain. Who's going to stop the wind here at Colburn Park? Triton's up 7-0 here on the Image 360 New Berlin, Wisconsin scoreboard. Now it's time for the Fix TV What's on Tap, presented by Fix TV. We got a triple header tomorrow. I'm going to be at Mishicot as they host Chilton Valders. Don't forget, Fix TV provides live streaming and recorded content available on Fire TV, Roku, and Apple TV. Make sure you download their free mobile app on Apple and Android. Get your fix with Fix TV. A ton of content on there, especially if you're an outdoorsman. They got a daily show. I've been kind of checking out every now and again when I have a little free moment at work, which is about once every 10 days. But some good content, covering a little bit of everything. Now adding high school sports to it.
So a leadoff hit by pitch. Megan Gelb standing down at first. Ava Massey standing in the batter's box.
There you go, 8-9-1, need three to end it here.
Runner goes, pop fly on the infield. Gelb's gonna have to retreat back to first. That's gonna
drop. That's a fair ball.
Now we're in a little bit of another run down here. Throw gets away into left field. Everyone's going to be safe.
Truthfully, I mean,
I don't really know how to score that, to be honest with you there.
Initially, Gelb's on second with an error on the throw.
Yeah.
With the wind. It's a base hit with the wind. But Gelb's still out there at second with it, a throwing error. I mean, if outside of the throwing error, if you're Sheboygan, not much you can play that day any different. Likewise, Notre Dame, Gelb did right on the base pass. Nothing you can do.
Back to the top of the order with Peters.
And I said three to end it, and we were only in the fourth, so we'll have to play at least the top half of the fifth if the Tritons were to scratch across three here in the bottom half.
Brand is still on the mound. She fires a ball outside. 2-0 the count. Peters singled her last time up. She also came around to score. That was back in the second.
You know, Dom, this is a key moment too right here for the player of the game, these next couple batters.
That's true.
They're vying for it.
Very similar in the scorebook. Wagner will step on third. Only play was there. So Gelb is out.
SBS Plumbing is owned by a master plumber. We have 25 years of plumbing experience. SBS proudly serves the Fox Valley and the surrounding areas, plumbing every home as if it were our own. Visit sbs-plumbing.com. That's sbs-plumbing.com.
Here's someone vying for a player of the game. Another base hit in the left. That's going to get all the way to the fence. One run will come in to score. Here comes Massey, and that's two. Is that another triple?
Oh, wow.
How about that?
That's tough. That's tough. She's in there. I throw beat her. I don't think tag was there, but it may not have been applied as the foot snuck in underneath of it.
Some aggressive base running once again. Peters and Massey came around to score. That makes it 9-0. Now the batter's Addie Simpson. Only one down in the fourth. That one's in there for a strike.
So as it stands right now, that will be the deciding run out there at third base in Yonner. Simpson looking to help her own cause here.
Takes a called strike two, nothing into the count.
I tell you what, now I'm sitting right on the outside edge of that the plate for a right-handed batter. And Brandon's got some nice spin to it.
Yeah. Now it's down low in the dirt, and really, you know, there's nine runs on the scoreboard, but you can thank the wind and a couple of throwing errors for a couple of those there. Just good base running from Notre Dame, very aggressive base running, which has probably squeaked out another couple runs for for their cause here. Simpson sends a fly ball to center field. That's going to be over the head of Yetzer. And there is the 10th run. Simpson will be in with an RBI double.
A double, a BAGM double, and the 10th run in the game. Another RBI for Simpson. Three of them on the afternoon. My goodness.
There's going to be a courtesy runner. Outstanding on second.
Looks like we're at Miller Park, except they have a dome. We don't.
Ah, dome sure would be nice.
Yeah.
It's all good, though. All good.
Blame it on the dumb dome. That's me. Left it in the old garage today.
Pitch to Kyle Waldrop is down low for ball two. Kaya still looking to get on base today. She's flown out and struck out her previous two appearances. Yeah. 2-0 pitch, swing and a ground ball be taken by Babbitt at short in time. Runner will advance.
Weird sound on that contact, and I thought almost initially it might be a cracked bat. Didn't seem like solid contact, even though she squared it up.
Ella Gelb will be batting, two down in the fourth. Makes a called strike one, 10-0 the score. They have a chance to add on one more. That's Sienna Calloway standing on third base.
Use a State Farm insurance run in the game here for Tritons. No, any insurance agencies out there, we'd take that sponsorship.
Would love that. Slow roller back to the mound. Throw will be in time to end the inning. Three more runs come in to score. They leave one stranded. If they can get three outs in the next half inning, the game will be over. 10-0 Notre Dame on the Image 360 New Berlin scoreboard. We'll be back to Colburn Park right after this. You're watching W7.
My younger brother got me into cycling about 15 years ago. After I was injured and the cartilage started to wear out in my left hip, is that I just became sedentary. Orthopedic Associate took such good care of me. I went in one day, came home the next day. 9 months after my hip surgery, I did a 150-mile bike ride. It's just been a great experience. I'm back doing everything that I was doing and more.
First pitch swinging there. Top of the fifth. You need at least one to keep playing if you're Sheboygan North. 7-8-9 due up here for the Red, or the, I say Red Raiders.
I made that mistake too. Yep, I made that mistake too. I was calling a Pulaski game the other day.
Ashworth doing the catching duties this afternoon. Looking to get the scoring started for the first time tonight.
Next pitch, swing and a miss.
Climbing the ladder a little bit there.
So a 1-2 count to the leadoff batter in the fifth inning, Ashworth. Down low, ball two. Two-two pitch coming, swing, and a called strike. Throw down to first will complete the strikeout. That's out number one.
In this scenario there, a all-important first out. What else is important coming out of winter? Cleaning up your yard, snap trees, broken branches, ugly stumps, and so much more. You need to get your spring cleaning going. There is no one better than All Wisconsin Tree Services. Visit allwitreeservices.com to get started.
First pitch was a ball to the pitcher, Emily Brantis. I believe there is actually a substitution there, so currently batting is number nine, Haley Bergstrom. No one's upstairs to her. Two-one count here. Simpson still going strong. That one just misses, top of the zone. Next pitch is a called ball four. There's going to be a courtesy runner. So a one-out walk.
One of the few blemishes this afternoon for Simpson, 4 1/3 pitch so far. 70 pitches, 35 of them in there for strikes. Faced 17 batters, walking just four, striking out three, giving up just one hit. Had a couple runners, you know, I've had a couple runners on, nearly going, but been able to pitch around it. Nice composure by Simpson out there in the circle this afternoon.
A little conversation here between one of the coaches from Sheboygan North and Paige Oldrick, who comes in. She was playing out in right field today. She's got a runner on first and one out. First pitch downstairs. Next offering from Simpson. I'm going to say she went around.
I was going to say, she didn't. Act worthy of an appeal.
Next one gets away. Throw down to first is not in time. Ball drop tried to pick off throw.
Now, we wouldn't venture too far down there.
2-1 count here. Next offering, big swing and a miss. That's strike two, count even at 2-2. That's a called strike three. Aldrich is retired and they are one out away from picking up their third win of the season.
One final chance to thank our sponsors of Triton Girls Softball, All Wisconsin Tree Services, Bay Care Orthopedic Sports Medicine, Bay Area Granite Marble, Happy Joe's Pizza, KI, Kemp's Ace Hardware. Uh-oh.
Fly ball left field, going back on it is Yonner, couldn't make the catch. This is going to more than likely score a run. Throw to the plate is in time.
And that is how it ends.
What a relay there from Yonner to Peters to Waldrop.
We're here with head coach.
Doesn't get much better than that, my friend, I'll tell you what. So your final, I was gonna say out of the Triton Center, but your final from Colburn Park, not from the Dub Dome. Triton's 10, Sheboygan North, nothing. Once again, big thank you to Triton Girls softball sponsors, Whipfley, Velocity, 360U, Town Line, Stat Information Solutions, Schneider, Schutz Bar and Grill, Synergy, Stars Realty, Rucker Milky, Ornu, and Kim Say's Hardware. Stick around, we have our Jolly Good Soda Player of the Game interview coming up next. All righty, we are back with our Jolly Good Soto player of the game. We lost all your teammates, but that's all right. They're, you know, picking up. But it is Clarissa Peters. Talk to me about that game today, just a little bit about, the wind and figuring things out as the game went on.
Oh, the wind was terrible today. I mean, shout out to the outfielders, even the infielders on the few pop-ups that we had. And, I mean, you would watch the runners, they're under it, and then they just completely move. So it's definitely an extra challenge playing outside.
Yeah, absolutely. A single, couple runs for you today. Kind of aggressive on the base paths. It looked like you guys were early. Is that kind of the mindset coming into this one?
Oh, we're always 100%. We want to be aggressive. We want to get those extra steals. And, you know, today was a perfect opportunity with the wind. And, you know, we're confident in our base running. So,
absolutely. What's it like playing, playing out there behind somebody like Addison Simpson? You know, she's going to throw a lot of strikes. She's going to, you know, people are going to put the ball in play. And, just having that confidence in you guys that you're going to make plays for her.
Oh, I love it. She is so mentally tough, you know, especially with the wind. When you're pitching, it's hard to pitch in wind. And,
yep.
You know, yeah, she might have started the game off with a walk, but immediately we come back, and I love playing behind her. So.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, talk a little bit about this team this year and kind of, as a senior, what makes this group special? And obviously you've kind of been part of this rebuild and really building the program up to a really competitive level.
I mean, you know, freshman and sophomore year, we didn't really win that many games, and last year we didn't have any seniors, so it really is a continuation from last year. We gained some freshmen too, so really building up the program. And, you know, we had Futures girl, Peyton. She was our back girl today, so also incorporating the Futures program because, you know, we're here for the high school team, but we're also here for the whole program.
Absolutely. And just talk a little bit for yourself, if you can leave kind of a, your, I don't want to say legacy, but if you can leave one thing behind with the program, what would you want that to be?
Especially because I'm not playing in college, you know, being able to have a program at Notre Dame and, you know, come back and, you know, this summer I was in the 10U dugouts, I think, once or twice, and watching the 12Us, the 14Us. I just want to be known as, like, a team player, not only for our team, but for the whole program.
Yeah, just that program kid.
Mm-hmm.
Well, hey, Clarissa Peters, our Jolly Good Soto player of the game. We got some Jolly Good here for you. I'll have to unearth that here in a second. That's where you're just like, oh, I get the Jolly Good, right? Yeah, absolutely. So I got a little six-pack over there for your Jolly Good. So make some friends. You guys playing tomorrow?
Yeah, we're heading down to Xavier
that's
1
right.
p.m.
Yep. I'm over at Michicott tomorrow, so I won't be down there with you guys. But I'll be following along Game Changer, so pick up a win or two there, and we'll reconnect next week. Clarissa Peters, our Jolly Good Soto player of the game, Fort Dom D'Angelo, who's now on camera duties for Clarissa Peters and the rest of the Triton softball program. You've been watching W7, and everything we do for the girls.
Give me land, lots of land under starry skies.